We're going to compute the volume of a sphere.
Well, here I've got a clay sphere, and if I measure it, I find that its diameter is about 4.2. The diameter is about 4.2 centimeters. So its radius, say 2.1 centimeters.
Now we're going to take this sphere and crush it flat.
And I want to make it so that it's about 1 centimeter thick.
Now I'll estimate the volume of that blob.
So if you measure this, the thing's maybe a bit under 7 centimeters by a bit over 5 centimeters, and it's 1 centimeter thick. So I'd guess that the volume is about 35 cubic centimeters.
That wasn't all that precise, but we can do the calculation precisely by taking the sphere, slicing it into disks, thin cylinders, integrating those thin cylinders, right? And that'll give us the exact volume of the sphere.
So we're going to take the sphere, and I'm going to slice this thing up into lots and lots of little tiny cylinders.
We have to figure out the radius of each of those thin cylinders.
Well, let me draw the picture again. Right, here's the plane. This is the y-axis and the x-axis. And I've got my circle in the xy plane. And here's the sphere sitting in space. And at some height, I'll call that height y, I've got a thin cylinder. And what I want to do is figure out the radius of that thin cylinder. Well, really what that amounts to is figuring out the coordinates of this point here, right? I want to figure out what that x coordinate is so that xy lands on that circle. Well, I know the equation for the circle in the xy plane. That's x squared plus y squared equals r squared. R is the radius of the sphere that I'm thinking about. And I can solve this for x. X equals the square root of r squared minus y squared. This is the radius of this little tiny thin blue cylinder here. And I'm going to cut up my sphere into a whole bunch of these little tiny cylinders and add up the volumes of those cylinders to give me the volume of the whole sphere. Now I'm going to figure out the volume of that thin cylinder. Now, what's the volume of this slice? What's the volume of that thin cylinder? Well, it's pi times the radius of that cylinder, which is given by this. So the radius is the square root of r squared minus y squared. And it's that radius squared, right? This is pi radius of cylinder squared times the height of that cylinder. Well, the height of that cylinder is dy. So this is giving me the volume of this thin cylinder.
We have to think about the endpoints of integration.
Well, how big and how small can y be? Well, y goes all the way down here to minus r, and y goes all the way up here to r. So when I set up my integral, I want to integrate this. Y goes from minus r to r.
Now we can integrate.
So first I'll simplify the integrand. This is the integral, y goes from minus r to r of pi times the square root squared. Just r squared minus y squared dy. Now I can simplify this a bit more. I've got a constant. I'll just pull that constant out. This is pi times the integral from minus r to r of r squared minus y squared dy. Now I've got to cook up an antiderivative of this, right, to use the fundamental theorem of calculus. So this will be pi times, so what's an antiderivative of just r squared? R is just a constant here. So an antiderivative of that will just be r squared times y minus an antiderivative of y squared is y cubed over 3. And I'll be evaluating that from r and minus r. But if you think about it a bit, I can get away with using 0 to r if I multiply this by 2. And that'll simplify the calculation somewhat. All right. Now I just got to plug in r and plug in 0. So when I plug in r, I get r squared times r minus r cubed over 3. And when I plug in 0, I just get 0. So I have to subtract that. And I can keep working on this. What do I have here? I got 2 pi r cubed minus 1/3 r cubed. Well, let's call this 3/3 r cubed, right? So this is now 2/3 r cubed times 2 pi. Well, this ends up being 4/3 pi r cubed.
We did it!
Yeah, the volume of a sphere here of radius r, we just calculated it. It's 4/3 pi r cubed.
And we could reach into even higher dimensions.
For example, you could try to write down an integral that calculates the volume of a hypersphere. What's a hypersphere? Well, that's the higher dimensional analog of just a regular old sphere. Right? A sphere is sort of a stack of circles, so a hypersphere will be a stack of spheres, but in the fourth dimension.